Are you a virgin?
Oh my. This is a spicy question. Did you ever take a girl to your hotel room, Marlon? Did you?
It's tough.
Oh my.
Cut.
Welcome to the official Bassjackers Q&A Ask Us Anything. And of course, you guys asked us a bunch of really cool questions, and we're gonna answer them right now.
No sex questions.
I saw a sex question.
Oh, yes.
First one, Big Orgus. When is it releasing?
I know the answer. I actually don't know it really, but I think it's the 27th of March.
It is.
Yes. Yeah.
That's the scheduled date.
Score.
So don't hold us to it, because sometimes things change. But as for now, March 27. How do you build your fan base?
To be honest, I would never think of building a fan base or such. Just do what you like. Play the music, make the music you like. And if the people come, they come, and if they don't come, they don't come. You shouldn't make music or play music because others like it. It's your vision on music. Stick to it.
So a lot of people wanted to know, why doesn't Ralph tour with Marlon?
I'm not a DJ. It's not that I don't like DJing, but I just like producing way more. Yeah, that's basically it.
How did you come up with the name Bassjackers?
Jack in the Bass, man.
Yeah, at the time we were like doing something they would call jacking house.
And we used a lot of bass. That's basically it.
And then
when he came up, we're actually jacking the bass. Bassjackers.
What is your favorite Bassjackers release? For me, I would say Mush Mush.
I actually liked when Memories came out.
So you'd say Memories?
Yeah.
Good memories for Memories. I'm sticking to Mush Mush.
Good
one. Yeah. Okay, so there's been a bunch of questions about new collaborations, which makes me want to say we just came off a track. All My Life, we did it together with Lucas and Steve, was kind of the follow-up for These Heights. We did that track like 2 years ago, and we wanted to do another one, so All My Life, if you didn't hear it yet, check it out. But people want to know if we're going to collab with Martin Garrix, Blaster Jacks, Timmy Trumpet, W&W, Hardwell, Quintino, Dr. Funk, Coon. I would say from those names, there's definitely some stuff in the working. I'm not going to say who, but yeah, it's coming. Oh, and then Blaster Jacks asks, when new Blaster Jacks and Bassjackers collab?
Let's do it. Why is
Timmy
the sky
Trumpet?
Blue?
Why is the sky blue? I think it has something to do with the molecules in the air reflecting the sunlight, and that blue light travels fastest. So Timmy, I'm not exactly sure, but you also have Google to look stuff like this up, okay?
I think you already Googled to look it up.
I had it in Natuurkunde. Now I Google it. W&W Music, another... Oh, this is all the questions from the...
What a new vlog.
Yeah.
Well, me and Wacht, we do a lot of cool vlogs. I think we're one of the most famous vloggers in the world. Yeah. Everybody wants to know when there's a new one. Well, I can tell you, I'm going to Wart really soon, so who knows.
Slam Official, when will we see you again? Good one.
Yeah.
We just had our track, All My Life. We would be happy to come to the studio and play it for you, or you play it for us, and then do a DJ set. So let's do it soon, guys. What is the biggest track coming this year? So many big ones. There's a lot of music coming up, guys. You know, this is
I do have a favorite
pointed out,
which is I Want You So Bad.
Ooh.
Like
I don't know if anyone heard it yet. If you check our live sets, I most definitely played it in one of those. And that's actually a big track. That's the one. So Bad.
Or I Want You. We're actually not sure what to call it.
Title to be announced.
Yeah.
But
hey, put it in the comments. Should we either make it I Want You or call it So Bad?
When does the new Lepe Bass EP will be out, will be released?
October.
What are some of your best tips for starting a song? How do you start a song? How do you do that?
It can be some different. So sometimes you just hear a cool sound, or you have this melody, and then even sometimes it starts with a kick. I introduce a kick real soon in the track, every track. That's, you build it around the kick. Your kick is your reference point. Sometimes you just get triggered with something, and if you don't, and you don't have a trigger, write melodies. It's always the best.
How to make white leads that sound also good in mono?
Don't make them too wide.
Yeah. It sounds so easy when he says it.
I know what you should do. Check Signed by Bassjackers.
For those who don't know, Signed by Bassjackers is where Ralph spills the magic beans about producing. So it's on our YouTube channel.
Yeah, it's in the description of the video. Here.
How to make intros for songs?
I don't have a tip how to do it, but what I dislike is when people make it too easy. An intro, especially when you send out an extended mix for a DJ to play, if those first seconds sound shitty, you're just like, meh, probably the rest is shitty as well. So make sure the first seconds sound cool right away.
And for me, from a DJ perspective, I would say don't put too much melodic stuff in the intro, because it makes it horrible to mix into the
track. And if your song is in triplets, don't make the intro triplets. Ooh, as well.
That's even worse. No triplets. What equipment do you favor the most when creating music?
My computer.
What kind of computer
do
you
use? Actually, no. I like my speakers.
Yeah?
My monitors.
Any brand or model?
No, whatever works. Don't work too loud. Your ears will get tired and you'll make bad decisions.
Okay, there's a question for Ralph and a question for Marlon. Oh, that's funny.
I like that.
So, how do you deal with lack of inspiration for Ralph?
There's always something to do. Finish some tracks, re-listen, maybe it can be better. Make that intro.
Question for Marlon. Favorite calisthenics exercise? My favorite one is actually a front lever, where you hang on a bar and you keep your whole body straight.
I knew it.
Yeah, because that's the one I can do. For all the people that don't know calisthenics and think, what is he talking about? Check it out. It's super cool. When are you going to give away a huge signature sample pack again?
Yes, it's almost finished. So soon.
Yeah. Soon. How do you take care of your hearing? Any recommendations for earplugs? Good question. I actually, about 10 years ago, already damaged my ears. That's when I started to wear earplugs. Maybe a little late, so if you don't have any damage yet, just start wearing it now, because it sucks.
I actually like them going to a club and have the earplugs in.
It needs some time when you're, I know, because when you're DJing and you're used to not playing with earplugs, when you just start using them, you need some time to adjust. It's gonna suck, but just after 2 weeks, you'll love it. It's even better. So what I use is earplugs with an ER filter. It filters the whole frequency spectrum, and I use the 25 dB cutoff, which is a lot, but because my ears are so sensitive, I have to. There's also 15 or 9 dB. Will Ralph join Marlon behind the decks in the next Lepe Bass Radio episode?
Oh, that's actually a fun idea.
Yeah, well, he sometimes if you really paid attention, he sometimes like pops in the camera and does like a little cameo. Yep. Yeah, why not? He can be there and maybe even mix a few tracks, show his DJ skills. Pretty sure he can DJ. Oh, a question in Dutch. Wat moet ik doen om met de Bassjackers een nummer te mogen maken? What do I have to do to produce a song with Bassjackers?
Make cool music we like.
Yeah. Make something that blows our minds and that this guy right here thinks, oh, we could do something really cool with this. And then it might happen. It happened before.
We worked with a lot of guys who just sent in cool ideas. Yeah, I remember. Even Martijn, Brooks, later on guys like Len and Respawn.
Yeah.
There's lots of guys who just send in ideas. And then we browsed through it and we're like, we like it.
How long did you produce before releasing anything?
Long. Yeah. Yeah. But those were different times. To be honest, we didn't produce to release. I think a release as a goal is weird. We just made music which we thought would be cool in sets, and not even for him only to play, but for other ones as well. We never sent it out to labels, we sent it out to DJs.
Does Ralph know how to DJ, or Marlon how to produce? I used to produce a little bit when we just started. Definitely didn't do it for a long time, but maybe if I dive into it again, I could do something.
Well, you're pretty badass with Ableton.
Yeah. I do a lot of edits and mashups, that kind of stuff.
And sometimes Ralph, play a record or two.
I've seen him DJ.
Yeah, but
he has some skills. You love the effects button and the mic pitch.
Oh. Yeah. Hand me the mic and I'll be rocking the place.
What's your favorite food? On tour, I always try to eat whatever is local. So yeah, Chinese food, Mexican food. I love pizzas, burgers. I just love trying new stuff. So in every country, I always try the local food.
I'll have to go for the croquette. It's a typical Dutch snack, which has some meat inside and stuff. It looks weird and the structure is weird. But for us here in Holland, it's really normal and it's really good.
Who inspired you guys to join the big room genre?
I think Afrojack.
Predecessor of big room was Dutch House, and Afrojack definitely inspired us.
Yeah. But also Sydney Sampson helped us a lot.
Sydney Sampson as well. What would be your job if you were not professional DJs?
You would be an international businessman, and I would be a finance dude.
Are you a virgin?
Oh my.
I'm an Aquarius and I had sex once. And this guy has a baby. Actually, there you go.
This is a spicy question. I like it. And it's for Marlon. Did you ever take home girls from a gig? Yes, Marlon. Did you?
No. And you know why? Because we always play abroad, so I'm not gonna take them home.
When we played in Holland. Took them home. Let's rephrase the question. Did you ever take a girl to your hotel room, Marlon?
No. Just to the restroom.
Oh my.
Cut. Yeah.
Yes.
And what about you? I've seen you at some shows.
Yes.
Backstage, talking to girls.
Yes.
Something
interesting people.
Yeah. What is the future of Big Room? We all know Big Room will never die. And the future will be big.
Yeah, just it will evolve, definitely.
Yeah. The future is bright. What was the best moment of your life? Damn.
I just had a little girl, which was pretty epic, I can tell you. That's the one.
Best moment of my life! No, I have no clue. There's so many great moments that it's too difficult for me to answer.
And
his answer is great, but it was also really easy, so you know. A collab with artists of other genres, for example, Frenchcore or raw style. I've heard it, it's extremely hard, but you know, like we have been going harder every year, you could say. So you never know.
If it sounds good, it is.
Yeah. If you could go back in time having the skills you have right now, what advice would you give young Ralph and Marlon that are just starting their careers as DJs and producers?
by Tesla.
Yeah, has nothing to do with his producing skills, but with his financial skills, I guess.
So no, yeah, what would I say? Just enjoy every moment, and yeah, that's it actually.
Yeah, I think Ralph's advice, just do what you love and enjoy it and enjoy everything on your way. Yeah, it's a good advice.
And buy Bitcoin.
Thanks for all the great questions. I hope you're happy with the answers we gave you.
Now give us a thumbs up.
Give us a thumbs up.
Put in the comments if you have any more questions or whatever. Tell your friends, your family and everybody else. And please hit the subscribe button. There's a lot more content coming up. So you'll be the one of the first to know when it's up.
Yeah, so thumbs up. See you next time.
Ciao.